28 at her friend's on Super Bowl Sunday. His mama died back in his teens. Her passing is still a horrific dream. Damian was as quiet as can be, and after his mama died, he got quieter and quieter. And after his great grandma passed on Thanksgiving, I think he lost his will to keep living. At least that's my opinion, but I'm not a mind reader. I'm a musician who don't hold no dominion in Ohio. Hell, I didn't even attend Damian's memorial. Damian had diabetes, and I put it like this: he didn't eat Wheaties. He was known for being evasive and sneaky. He was known for taking off and disappearing for days. He never shared his innermost thoughts. In his eyes, I could see he was anxious and lost. And I'm told that he was into some other things that I dare not say, for his grandma would be mad at me. His grandmother is my favorite cousin. She gets me and I get her. We don't have to speak to understand each other. We shine like the shining. We're like sister and brother. Next door, there's a party going on while I'm down in the bunker writing songs. It's been a long time since I've been invited to a party. I guess I'm getting older and less exciting. But it's okay, I'm glad they don't come knocking. They're drunk, and on top of it, they're playing Jack Johnson. As I age, I prefer sitting home and watching true crime series, the news, and boxing. And tonight, when I get home, I'm gonna get under my covers and turn my electric blanket on and read about Jack Dempsey's life and times in the 1920s, about Hollywood and Prohibition, his long famous bouts, his obscure exhibitions, his rise from poverty to lots of money, his win over Willard, his loss to Tunney. Say a prayer for my Aunt Carolyn. I'm gonna say a prayer for my favorite cousin. I'll say a prayer for my mom and dad. I'll say a prayer for my girlfriend and her cat. I'll say a prayer for my sister and my friend. I'll say a prayer for young Damian.